Today we are going to learn magnetic field on the axis of a circular current loop. So we have learned the magnetic field produced on a current carrying conductor, and also we learned how to calculate the magnitude of the current carrying conductor and by using Biot-Savart's law. And here, to calculate the magnetic field on the axis of a circular current loop, we use Biot-Savart's law to calculate the magnitude of the magnetic field. Here we consider a circular current loop through which a current I is flowing, and the center of the loop is O, and we consider a point from O to the plane of the paper at the point P. So here we need to calculate the magnetic field at the point P, and the current flowing through the conductor in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, the current is flowing through the conductor or the wire, current loop is in the anti-clockwise direction, and the point P is located from the center of the loop at a distance x. So how we can calculate the magnetic field produced here? So here the current element dl, okay, that is the current element I into dl at the point here we consider the current element dl, okay, and the current element dl is in the anti-clockwise direction, okay, and also we consider another point opposite to this current element dl here, that is dl dash. So according to the Biot-Savart's law, we know that the magnitude of the magnetic field produced by the current element dl is equal to mu 0 4 pi into I into dl sin theta divided by r square. So in order to calculate the total magnetic field produced by this current loop, so first, as per the Biot-Savart's law, we need to divide this circular loop into small length elements dl, and we need to calculate the magnetic field produced by each small current element I dl separately, and then we need to integrate them together, then only we will get the total magnetic field produced on the axis of the circular current loop. So for a small current element, and assume that we have divided this current circular wire or loop into small length element dl, so the magnetic field produced on that small current element dB is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi I dl sin theta divided by r square. Let us calculate the magnetic field produced at the small current element I dl at the point P. So how we can calculate that is equal to dB is equal to mu 0 4 pi into I dl, and what is angle? The magnitude of the magnetic field produced by the current element I dl at the point P is maximum when the angle sine or theta is equal to 90 degree. So instead of the sine theta, we can substitute sine 90 degree divided by r square. And what is the r square? R square is the distance r. And what is the distance? We are calculating the current element I into dl here. And from the center point of the current element I dl to the point P, if we draw a position vector, now what will be the value? And this is the value of r, that is equal to square root of a square plus x square. Okay, this is the hypotenuse of, and this makes a right angle triangle. And in order to find out the value of this hypotenuse, so we will get r is equal to the square root a square plus x square, mu 0 4 pi I into dl sin 90 is equal to 1, then I into dl divided by r square. and the r square will be a square plus x square. R is equal to under square a square plus x square. Then the r square will be a square plus x square. Now we can calculate here the see the current element dl, I into dl. So the circular loop is arranged in such a way that the dotted line of the one part of this circular loop is behind this the plane of paper, and the other part from here to here is arrayed or it is visualized in such a way that it is the front side of the plane of the paper. Okay, so and then if it is so, how we can calculate the direction of the current element ideal? So here the current is flowing along this direction. Okay, so that means from the back side towards the front side. So and also we know that the direction of the current element, which is a vector quantity whose direction is always along the direction of flow of current. So then this direction of this current element ideal at this point is in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, this will be the direction of current element I into dl. And here we got the value of r is equal to square root of a square plus x square. Same way, if we consider another current element exactly opposite, that means the perpendicular to the center of O, then which can be taken as dl dash at the point D, and this is taken at the point C. And the same way when we can get, okay, this is also from the center at a distance r. Here A is the radius of the circular loop. So then this value, this also will be A, and this distance is x square. Same way, the magnetic field produced by the current element IdL dash at the point P can be calculated as what it is, dB dash, that is equal to mu 0 4 pi into I into dl dash. Then the distance is, there is a hypotenuse from the point D to P. Okay, so this also will be r is equal to square root of a square plus x square. Okay, then this value become then r square. R square will be a square plus x square. Okay, here we assume that the current element dl is equal to dl dash. Okay, here we assume that what dl is equal to dl dash. Hence what happens, the magnetic field produced by the current element dl at the point P is equal to, that is dB is equal to dB dash. How we can calculate the total magnetic field of this current loop? So in order to calculate the total magnetic field, when we take the position vector r, and if we take the position vector r, what will be the direction of the magnetic field produced here, that is dB? What will be its direction of dB? And here we know that the direction of the current element dI is in the anti-clockwise direction outwardly to the plane of paper. Okay, so then if it is so, if it is anti-clockwise direction and outwardly to the plane of paper, then what will be that magnetic field produced here, which will be the perpendicular to the position vector here. Okay, as per the rule, it is perpendicular to the position vector. Then so this will be the direction of dB. And the same way, if you consider the direction of magnetic field produced by the current element dl dash at the point dB, the point P, then what will be the direction of the magnetic field produced here? So as we know that this is the r dash is the position vector. Okay, r dash is the position vector, and this position vector and the direction of the current element dl is equal to anti-clockwise direction but opposite to the first, that means it is inwardly towards the plane of paper. So that means here the direction of current element is changed or reversed. Okay, so then the direction of the magnetic field produced will be perpendicular to the position vector r in the downward direction. So this will be the direction of dB dash. In order to find out this, the strength of magnitude of total magnetic field produced by the current element dl and dl dash and along the circular loop, then we need to integrate this all small current element together so that we can get the total magnetic field produced here. So in order to calculate this total magnetic field, so we need to consider two components: the direction of this current element or direction of the position vector along this direction of the magnetic field and perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. So here, if it takes along the direction of magnetic field, so this will be dB sin theta. Okay, so if you consider this magnetic field produced by the current element dl at the point P, dB, so along this is the direction of the along the direction of dB, then this will be dB sin theta. And if you take this perpendicular component, this will be dB cos theta. And the same way, if we calculate the direction of magnetic field or the position vector R by the current element dl dash at the point P, so how we can get, so another one, the sine component dB dash sin theta and the perpendicular component dB dash cos theta. And now here the angle here made, okay, so assume that this angle is phi, and by the symmetry, and this angle also will be phi, and here this angle is 90 degree, then this angle will be 90 minus phi, and so this angle will be phi. Then the same way, this angle will be 90 minus phi, so therefore this angle also will be phi. Okay, so now here what happens to the cos component? Here this cos component by the magnetic field produced by the current element dl and dl dash, both they are opposite direction. Okay, so dB cos theta and dB dash cos theta, the magnitude of these two components are equal, but they are in opposite direction. So therefore, what will happen to this component? These two components will be cancelled each other. And but what about the sine component? Here the dB sin theta, that is the sine component of the dB and dB dash sin theta, and these two components will be added together. Okay, so therefore, and now we can write the total magnetic field produced by this circular current loop at the point P can be write as, what is the total magnetic field? That is B. Okay. Integral of dB sin phi. dB already we know that mu 0 4 pi into I into dl sin phi divided by r, instead of r square, what is r square? A square plus x square. Then B can be written as B is equal to, and here this mu 0 divided by 4 pi is a constant here. Okay, and the current flowing through the circular loop is also constant. So these two values are constant, and the distance a square plus x square, that also does not change. So these 10 can be write together. So you will write mu 0 into I divided by 4 pi a square plus x square. Then what is the 10 remaining? dl into sin phi. The angle was also does not change, then sin phi into integral dl. So here sin phi can be written as sin phi is equal to a divided by square root of a square plus x square. Okay, then this value can be substituted in this equation. So what we get? Mu 0 into I divided by 4 pi into a square plus x square into, then what is sin phi? Sin phi is equal to a divided by square root of a square plus x square into, and also the value of dl. What is dl? Dl is equal to 2 pi a. Here the value of dl can be substituted as 2 pi a. That is, a is the radius of the circular loop. So this value also can be substituted in this equation. Integral instead of into integral dl, we can write 2 pi a. That is, when these all small components they are added together, that will become the circumference of the circular loop. That is equal to, and this 2 pi and 4 pi will be 2, then mu 0 I into a. Here a into a square divided by, then a square plus x square into, square root of a square plus x square will be a square plus x square whole raised to 3 by 2. So this is the total magnetic field produced by a on the axis of a circular current loop is given as b is equal to mu 0 I into a square divided by 2 into a square plus x square whole raised to 3 by 2. If there are n terms, so here we are talking about only a single loop, and if there are n terms for the circular loop, then what will be its value? Then its value will be, this is the magnetic field produced by a single circular loop. Then if there are n terms, and this can be written as B is equal to mu 0 into I a square into n divided by 2 into a square plus x square. So that will be the total magnetic field produced by, if there are n times of current loop. A special case is, here we have located a point which is away from the center of the circular loop, where at the point P. And what if the point is on the center of the circular loop? So if the center of the circular loop, then means what? The value of x will be, x is equal to 0 then. Okay, the value of x is equal to 0. The value of x is equal to 0, then this distance is 0. Then what about this total magnetic field produced here? The total magnetic field produced here will be, okay, if x is equal to 0, then the value of B is equal to mu 0 into I into a square divided by 2 into a cube. That means this value can be written as B0 is equal to, if the point located is on the center of the circular loop, then B0 is equal to mu into n into I divided by 2e. This is if the point that we located is on the center. That means, and if we represent them graphically, if a graph is plotted, here the value of x is equal to 0, and here the point x is equal to x as a value. And then what will be the magnetic field produced here? Okay. So this is the value of B0. And the value of the magnetic field is maximum, and the value of, so this will be the total magnetic field produced by the circular loop if the value of x is equal to 0. That means the point is located on the center of the circular loop. That means if the point is away from the center of the circular loop, then the strength or the magnitude of the magnetic field produced is decreasing. The direction of the magnetic field produced here can be described with the help of right hand thumb rule. And we know that as per the right hand thumb rule, if the current carrying conductor is held by our right hand in such a way that the all fingers which are encircled around the circular loop is in the anti-clockwise direction, then the thumb will show the direction of the magnetic field produced here. That means it will be in the downward direction. And if the circles which are encircled around the current carrying loop, which is in the clockwise direction, then that the direction of the magnetic field produced here will show the direction of thumb, and which will be in the upward direction. So that's all about the magnetic field on the axis of a circular current loop. I hope you understand.